This is my first ever 360 photo, taken back in 2015 with a 6 megapixel 360 camera. This is that same photo after 10 seconds of editing inside Topaz Photo AI. I promise it's not fake. Holy. As a 360 photographer, everything changed the day I discovered the previous Topaz products, Denoise and Gigapixel. 360 photos aren't exactly known for being sharp and smooth, but with a few clicks of a button and the moving of a slider or two, I discovered I could instantly double the image quality of my virtual tour shots, even with older photos taken several years ago. OMG. So now in 2022, Topaz have just released Photo AI, which seems to be an attempt of combining all of their previous softwares and the various functions into one. But did they do this successfully? In this video, I'm going to dive into Topaz Photo AI, just how good it is, how it compares to the other Topaz software, and if you should spend $200 on it or stick with what you've already got. If you're keen to double your image quality, then be sure to stay to the end to get all the answers. Now, I'll start by saying that Photo AI can be used for both regular photos and 360 photos. It's a no-brainer that it works with smartphone, DSLR, whatever camera you own that shoots flat photos, but also for the 360 community, Photo AI is 360 friendly. Just like before, you can use Photo AI either as a standalone program or as a plugin within Photoshop or Lightroom. The interface is really similar to previous Topaz products, where the sliders and settings are on the right-hand side and the main preview window with the before and after is occupying the majority of the window. And my personal preference is the side-by-side, so you can see the before and after, but they do also have the split screen, or you can just go full screen and click to see your before and after. And what I've done here is intentionally shot a very noisy and cropped in photo. It's from a 4K video shot at ISO 6400, and I cropped in to less than a tenth of the frame. And you can see automatically Photo AI has gone to work to try and improve this image based on what it thinks the photo needs. This is called the Autopilot feature, where it automatically detects a subject. As you can see, it's done a really good job isolating my face and hands. And internally, it's saying, let's denoise and sharpen the face as you would do to a face, and everything else should be denoised and sharpened in a different way that might be a bit more aggressive, because as you probably know, over sharpening does not look good on faces. And you are able to refine your mask if you like by increasing or decreasing the sensitivity, so how much of the subject it chooses, as well as the softness of the mask. I like mine nice and soft. So right there, without doing anything at all really, Photo AI has done a really good job at this low quality photo. Now you can go further into this and adjust the settings to your taste. So let's try with extreme noise removal. And I think that's better yet again. You can choose the strong option for extremely noisy shots, but I find sometimes that blurs other areas. So if you can get away with normal, I'd do that. The detail slider preserves detail that was there before. So like the crease in my jumper, you don't want that stuff disappearing completely. I'm not going to go too aggressive here, because if you preserve too much detail, it's also going to preserve some of the noise that it thinks is detail in your shot. So I'm gonna keep it around 10 because I'm happy overall with the level of detail across this image. And we haven't even got to sharpening yet. So let's do it, shall we? Underneath remove noise, you'll find sharpen. And I always like toggling everything on and off and trying the different modes. Just so you know, every single photo and situation will require a slightly different approach, and you won't know until you try everything. So I'm gonna zoom in nice and close. And there's three options: standard, lens blur, and motion blur. These are essentially sharpening settings optimized for the reason that your shot might be blurry. Is it because of the lens? Is it because it's motion blur? Or is it just low quality? And I'm liking lens blur. That's definitely sharper than before. And again, you can play with the sliders manually, bring them all the way up to see what that looks like. It does help to look around your shot to see if it has any negative effects elsewhere. So as you can see, the lines on my hand, it just looks sharpened. So I've gone too far with the strength of that. What happens if I move it all the way back? It's still there. So that tells me I need to choose a different sharpen mode. Let's go standard. And for sure, standard looks the most natural. Now back to my face. Yep, that's still sharper than before. I'm gonna play around with strength and clarity. And you gotta be careful not to overdo it here. I know it might be tempting to drag the sliders all the way to the right with every single photo, but again, that can give it that over sharpened look. So it's all about finding the sweet spot of what looks normal and natural. And in most cases, that's at 50% intensity or less. We've got a recover faces option. As you can see when I drag the slider to zero, that's what it would look like if it didn't detect the face. It looks like graphic artwork, and that's obviously not a good thing for portraits. So the recover face feature is definitely a good one to have for more natural looking portraits. Finally, we've got enhanced resolution, and in order to activate this, we're going to need to upscale our image. And this shot is low quality because it's a crop of a 3840 by 2160 image. So as you can see down the bottom, you can see the new widths and heights if you choose 1x, 2x, 4x, and max, if you do in fact want to increase the dimensions of your shot. And I do, so I'm going to go with 2x, which for me is 2140 by 1204. The final option is enhanced resolution, and what this does is when Photo AI upscales your shots, it's adding new pixels in there to try and intelligently add the missing pixels that could've, should've, would've been there. So let's zoom in really close into my eye and take a look at that. The eye on the left is definitely pixelated. The eye on the right, much less so. That is a really good feature. It's added pixels very accurately as to what it predicted would be there. And like the other modes, there are a few different options you can choose. You've got low resolution, graphic, which is more for digital art and not portraits, and there's natural. So choose whichever one looks best to you. For me, it's low resolution because this shot is definitely low resolution. So there we have our before and after, and it is so much better after. Not only do we have way less noise in the background and on my shirt and face, but also we've got a lot more clarity and less pixels overall when we zoom in close, making this look like a much more high quality image than what we started with. Not only that, but it's literally 4x the size as our original. I know it says 2x here, but by 2x, it means 2x this way and 2x this way, which is actually 4x. Okay, so I think we can agree Photo AI did a great job, but how does it compare to previous Topaz products? I've been using Gigapixel and Denoise for the past few years, and they've been unbeatable. I haven't seen anything better than them, including native upscaling, sharpening, and denoising within Photoshop and Lightroom. Well, I did an interesting experiment. Now, for some strange reason, all Topaz products to this point have both a sharpening and a denoising feature somewhere. So in this experiment, I tried using the sharpening and denoising sliders within each of the native programs to see what it looks like when using one software only. On the left, I've got the original, then the Photo AI version, then the Topaz Gigapixel version, then the Denoise version, and the last one you probably think is Topaz Sharpen, but actually, I haven't really found much use for Topaz Sharpen. I really feel like Denoise and Gigapixel are the leaders by far, and I haven't seen anything within Sharpen AI that those two softwares can't do. So our last photo on the right-hand side is actually Denoise and then Gigapixel, which is my workflow of choice in many situations, especially virtual tours where you're not actually shooting faces. But I thought I'd try it anyway with this shot. But taking a look at these, and there are some really good results in a couple of them. I think we can agree that Denoise isn't that strong on its own when it comes to working with faces. I think Gigapixel is doing a fantastic job at both sharpening and denoising, as is the Denoise and Gigapixel combination. But for me, Photo AI does the best job at faces. To me, this looks the most natural. It's done a great job at denoising, even though it isn't perfect, but it's really sharpened my eyes, nose, and general face. So if you do mostly shoot people, then Photo AI is looking really, really strong. So let's give this one to Photo AI. And I do think you could totally use Gigapixel on its own if you're shooting portraits. Next, I put them side by side in a virtual tour situation. So I shot this photo with my Insta360 X3, which I'll link below, and this is only a $400 camera. So you really shouldn't expect miracles with it. That said, I think these softwares will be able to work miracles with it. So I started with the exact same photo, and here are the results I got. So let's start at the clock. If you start by looking at the original, that's pretty blurry. And I think for sure Photo AI did a good job, as did Gigapixel and Denoise. Then with the Denoise and Gigapixel combination, not only do we not have a single piece of noise, but we also have the sharpest numbers of all five shots. I just want to zoom in a bit closer so you can really see. So looking at the 12 and the clock hands, it's definitely sharper with the Denoise and Gigapixel combination. I probably did over sharpen it, to be honest, but from a wider perspective, it won't be that noticeable. Still though, look at the difference. When you go back to the original and then Denoise and Gigapixel, it's miles better. Going to another part of the shot, and it's looking a bit more even. In fact, I'd say that Photo AI is probably the best. And keep in mind that we are at an extreme level of zoom here. Looking at this pillar again, all four workflows do a good job, but I'd probably say the Denoise or the Denoise and Gigapixel combination are the best. I've really found Denoise to be so good with any kind of wall or flat color where it's just a magnet for noise and artifacts, and Denoise wipes it away like it's a windscreen wiper. Also, the pillar does seem to be the sharpest with the Denoise and Gigapixel combination. I found Gigapixel also to be fantastic for having a really good sharpening algorithm for inanimate objects. Overall though, I found Photo AI does perform extremely well and is very close to Denoise and Gigapixel. Let's take one last look. Here's the painting in my stairway. And to me, this one's pretty obvious that Denoise and Gigapixel combination is the winner. The brush strokes of the painting are the sharpest, and the gradient also seems really smooth in the whites behind the elephant, whereas the others have these little pixelated bits and blurry lines in general. So for real estate, virtual tours, any kind of architectural work where there isn't faces, the combination of Denoise and Gigapixel is a winner. I've been using this workflow for years and I still feel like it's the best. One final comparison note, it seems that Photo AI produces the lowest file sizes overall, which is definitely handy because if your shots are massive, they're not going to turn into half a gigabyte per photo and make it hard to upload and download. Instead, it seems to compress it nicely, maximizing quality and minimizing space. Now, I feel like I need to state the obvious here and say that my edits aren't perfect. No doubt you could get slightly better results with all programs. However, for the sake of speediness, I gave each software about the same amount of time trying to get the best results for noise and sharpening, which was about 5 minutes per software. Now let's talk about the big question, and that is pricing. The regular price in late 2022 for Photo AI is $199. For Gigapixel, Denoise, Sharpen, and the whole image quality bundle, the normal price is $259. However, I do also see them on sale frequently for $199 or less. If you want me to notify you when any of the Topaz softwares go on sale, then sign up to my email list below and I'll shoot you an email when I see them on sale. So with prices around the $200 mark for all software, is it worth it? Yes, it absolutely is. Because when you're doing professional work for paid clients and you have a tool that can help you double your image quality, especially for us 360 photographers, where point and shoot 360 cameras don't always deliver the sharpest images for virtual tours, then Topaz software is a blessing and will mean you can produce higher quality work and in turn charge more for that higher quality work. If you want to learn how to land your own paid photo, video, and virtual tour clients, you can do so inside my two major online courses, which reveal all of my best business strategies for earning good money with your camera so you can finally go full time with it. You can learn more about both courses by following the links in the description. So while I truly do think all contenders are worth the money you pay, should you? I think there are different circumstances for when you would buy each specific product. So if you haven't bought any Topaz products at all and you want to start increasing your image quality and removing noise from your shots, then I'd probably just start with Photo AI. Everything is there in one, you don't need multiple software running at once, and it delivers results that are good enough. And while it's not always better than Denoise and Gigapixel, the workflow will be simpler, the file sizes will be lower, and the overall end result is still going to be significantly better than your before photos. If you're okay with a slightly longer workflow and you're shooting a lot of content that isn't so much people-based, so real estate, architecture, landscapes, virtual tours, where you really do need high quality on those inanimate objects, then I'd probably still get Gigapixel and Denoise. They really do look fantastic, and these two softwares have been my go-to for the past several years shooting virtual tours. What about if you already own Gigapixel, Denoise, or Sharpen? Well, I think you can probably guess I'd just keep them. They do a great job, and your results aren't really going to be any better with Photo AI, except in very specific circumstances, like if you're shooting a lot of portraits and you want to try multiple softwares to see which one delivers the best result for sharpening and denoising, then I guess I'd get Photo AI, but it really is not essential. Overall, I do like where Topaz are going with Photo AI, but I still think it's very early days and it's not an obvious upgrade at this point in time. I'll finish by saying that there are obviously other apps outside of Topaz products that can achieve similar results. So it's definitely not a one-horse race. That said, if you have any suggestions for other software that achieves the same or better result, be sure to let me know down below. That's it for this video. Let me know if you have any questions. Again, subscribe to my email list if you want me to send you discounts when they come along for all Topaz software. Peace out.